Hey, y'all, it's Brian Lord. Welcome back to Rome Total War as the Scipii. From our last time, we landed parties in Cydonia and Rhodes, respectively. And the Greeks have a large army there. We also sent a guy up here to help the Julii and Brutii fight off the Gauls. And everything else is looking pretty peachy keen, if I do say so myself. First thing we're going to do today is I'm going to look at our Senate information here. Macedon seems to be pretty happy with. We got one turn to blockade Carthage. You're going to ignore that. The Julii are falling behind in the people, but we're all the same on the Senate. And if we look at the overall ranking, we are above the other two factions with military as well as overall. And production, territorial, we also are defeating them. Financially, we are behind, however. But population, we're also ahead. So we're ahead in everything but financial. So that's pretty good. Financial's kind of the least important. Because that means I'm spending all my money, right? So there you go. And, yeah, we got this large Greek army with a decent commander to worry about, so we'll see. I think we'll be alright, but, you never know. Sorry. Oh, goodness. Sorry. Give the end of the turn there, and, see. I'm sure the Greek army's gonna attack us. And there we go. Holy cow, we have the same number of men. Did you see that? I'm pretty sure we have the same number of men. They got 3 units of Cretan archers. Holy cow, that's kind of powerful. But we have the same number of men in our armies, and then they got their faction leader here with a unit of hoplites and militia cav, so that's pretty cool. Yeah, we have no choice but to engage. Well, I guess we could retreat, probably onto the boats, but what's the point of doing that? Just give them a chance to build up more troops. Let's go. Right now. Battle on, baby. Sorry about that little abrupt thing. Something popped up during the loading screen, so I had to cut that out. And as you saw in that speech, he did refer to the other army having stronger men. So, like I said in, I believe, 2 episodes ago, perhaps, they aren't always egotistical and like, yeah, the Romans are the best. Sometimes they admit that the enemy soldiers are better trained, which is a problem that we're going to have to face here. We do have a nice little hill in front of us, however, so the first army shouldn't be too bad. It's whether those reinforcements can come in and hurt us. I think we got this, guys. But we'll see. Who is she? Move all of our missile troops out like that, and then that should be good. Make sure their firewall is off, and move our Equites. Might as well move them over here. There we go. Start the battle. And they got quite a bit spread out formation. We're gonna move our general over here. We're gonna engage the militia cavalry on the right flank. As you see there, get rid of those guys as soon as we can would be beneficial. Gonna move our main melee corps, or our foot troops, up so we can get a good hill advantage and our archers just be able to start firing at them pretty soon. And their secondary army did come in right away, unfortunately, so they're gonna have more militia cav and the strong general, their faction leader, as well as another unit of hoplites. But hopefully we should be able to counter that. And we're gonna take our cavalry department and head out. And if you hear any kind of loud noises in the background, that's probably da-na-na-na-na-na-na thunder, you know, so just to be warned. Actually, we're gonna peel off and try to hit these Cretan archers while we can. Actually, it looks like they're gonna charge in with their Greek cavalry, so we should probably counter that. Sound cry command, and we just totally destroyed those Greek cavalry. That's pretty nice. They didn't really put too much hurt on us, and these mushed cavalry aren't doing too much either. They're easily routed, and we should be able to charge right into these Cretan archers while hunting down some of the cav. So that worked out pretty well. They are peppering us with missiles already. Probably some of the Cretan archers are firing. But not too bad, casualty-wise. We should be able to take these guys out pretty quickly. They're archers, after all. I said pretty quickly. Come on. Come on, we need to attack the other Cretan archers if we can. There we go. Now they're routing. Charge into these other Cretan archers over here. And if we take out all the Cretan archers, we'll have the archer advantage. So that'll be big for us. Yeah. Looks like we should be able to as well, so that'll be nice. Gonna pause it here. Looks like they're moving up their hoplites. We are throwing our javelins, and that's looking pretty good. We've weakened this unit significantly. And we're gonna move out our Histati. Oh, he routed already, so we can move our Histati this way. Gonna pause it and order issues. Issue orders. Order issues, yes! That's exactly what I want to say. And, looks like our mercenary hoplites are actually avoiding conflict, which is unfortunate, because they're probably the best at fighting hoplites. And we kind of have to fight in melee with them, but we can get some flanking action with some of our troops. And it looks like some enemy militia cav came in to help, but we were able to cut them down pretty easily. And holy cow, that unit's getting tore up. We need a sound of cry command. Which one is this? Oh, right here. Yeah, that might not end too well. But we should be able to... Oh, shoot. He's starting to route. That's not good. Oh, come on, guys. Guys, hold together. Hold together. Oh, no. That's not good. Finish off these archers and get back there and help. Actually, we can't wait. We gotta go now. We are hurting them pretty bad on this flank. We've routed two of their hoplites. So we still have some strong men, and we need to get our mercenary peltis and some of our men just into melee combat, some of those ranged units, just to hold the line. And we can charge the general. Their general's down to only a couple units, so we can take out their general. Come on, kill him, kill him! Maybe. Nope. Looks like we didn't get him. But we made him rout, so that's good. And we're going to charge in with into that hoplite unit, this hoplite unit as well. And I'll make sure to shoot these enemy peltis. And this is definitely getting pretty crazy here. High casualties. Lots of our men came back from routing, so that's perfect. We got about 200 Histati that came back from routing. That's exactly what we need. And okay, we cleaned up that unit there. And there's a Thunderboom. Hear that. I don't know if the microphone will pick that up along with the game noise and stuff. But yeah. We're going to charge into the back here, even though some of them went in front like idiots. And we got these Histati here, and mercenary hoplites came back from rounding. We can retreat these archers, try to get them away from this action here. They're on skirmish mode. It's one time where it's useful. And route that unit there. Let's charge into this unit here. And we should be able to break that and then go save our archers on that other unit right there. Oh, they routed anyway. So, very nice, very nice. All right, I think we still have a good chance here. The balance bar is still about even, which is okay, I guess, but... I think we got this. We can just, if we can route these mercenary peltis, we have a pretty good shot, I would say. We just need to maneuver around them correctly. Pull our cavalry out like so, and get our mercenary hoplites to pin them as we try to outflank them. Or have our mercenary hoplites outflank them and pin them with some Histati. And there we go. Took that unit out. So that went pretty well. And they still got quite a bit of cavalry. We do not have the cavalry advantage. These archers are way out in the open, crap. Oh, man. They're sending in their faction leader to try to deal with it. And, they're gonna be able to route these archers really easily. But, maybe we can catch some of them. Hopefully. Maybe. No, our Ecotase routed immediately. We need to get our general out of here. Try to draw their general into our main body of... warriors, and that will give us an advantage. We should be able to hunt them down like that if we can. That would be a good idea. Alright, guys, get into melee range here, and we'll swing around into the back with our general cav, and we should be able to take down their general. Oh, come on, don't rout! Don't rout! Come on! Hold together, guys. Hold together. Oh, no! Oh, shoot, shoot, shoot! Come on! We could have won that! We could have won that! And you just had to route. Oh, goodness. Oh, this is... And the general's routing. These mercenary hoplites are still fighting. Yeah, go mercenaries. I think a mercenary is the only ones that are fighting, besides the archers. Now it's basically take as many casualties as you can before we lose kind of dealio here. So we'll fire at the enemy general. Maybe we can pick him off with our archers. Who knows? That'd be pretty amazing. Well, that's a very unfortunate battle, but if we can't kill their fashion leader, that would be very redeeming. Although, I don't know if that's possible. Our general came back from routing, so maybe he can launch a strike on their general. Everybody, all the ranged units attack their general, see if we can hunt down a bunch of their men. Oh, they're down to 36 from, like, a 90 at the beginning of the battle, so that went pretty well. And we need to pull out our general. He's not going to survive that engagement. And I get some more range shots off. Looks like the Mushi Cav are going to hit those guys and destroy them. A couple more shots with the archers, and maybe we can take these guys out. Yep, okay. For some men, even the favor of the enemy snatched victory at the last. Well, we did take quite a bit of casualties, though. I mean, I think we took more casualties than they took on us. Our general survived. They should retreat to the ship, but we lost most of the army. We're probably going to head back to Sparta, or even all the way back to the other place. What? Why are they attacking us here? They only have 6 units. What are they doing? Okay, look, we have a shot here. We can take Rhodes. We can avenge the defeat of our brothers. Go, Gaius. You can do it. Honestly, I probably lost that last battle because the guy didn't have any command stars. If I would have had Gaius there instead, I'm pretty sure we would have won that. So, that does go to show the importance of leadership. So, don't ever underestimate the power of command stars.
Take up the shield, grasp the spear, sharpen the sword's edge. This is a day of destiny, and fate of many will be decided in this place. Today we face those masters of lies, falsehood, and perversity, the Greeks. Beware of victorious Greeks, for they show little mercy.
Yes, they crushed most of our army.
In this particular game is theirs, I think.
On
this field, we have the benefit of greater numbers. It is one we would do well not to squander. Last time I fought those men, we were unlucky.
Not you.
It is now time to take revenge for that defeat.
Sometimes it doesn't.
Teach them to fear us anew. Now I say, this far and no further, here we make a stand. You all know my worth and what I have done before. Of the foes who attacked me in the past, few ever got to boast of their success.
True that. In fact, I don't think anyone can speak Gaius.
Priestly naysayers. They are holy men, not warriors. And a warrior makes his own fate.
True.
Now then, look to your front. Mark your target when it comes!
Solid speech. Gaius must have heard word about the defeat at Cydonia. But he's confident that he can win here. And I think we can. Look at these Histati. They got 8 armor with that +3 upgrade. So they're pretty heavy. They're better than standard Principes now. Of course, if we have Principes with gold, I mean, hoofda. I'm still trying to decide how are we going to want to form up here. I guess we'll use the Scorpions again. Might as well. We may get rid of our Scorpions after this little campaign here. I'm not too sure. Because they do slow down the army a little bit. Slow down the army speed. And they're not too helpful. As we've seen. I don't really enjoy using them. So, may not. And as you see, I put them on the side next to the coast. So, it should be fine. Plus, there's really not any much enemy cavalry. This first army here is comprised of 2 Militia Hoplites and a normal Hoplite unit. The secondary army is comprised of a Militia Hoplite, and their faction heir, I believe. Or maybe this is the faction leader and the other guy's the faction heir. I don't remember. But, excuse me. These guys should be coming up probably pretty slowly, but we'll watch the Scorpions. Perhaps they can get some damage off. They won't get any friendly fire from this angle, so that'll be helpful. And they shouldn't get run down by the Hoplites. And if they do, you know, we can counter that with cavalry and Histati. So, no worries. And as you see in the background, there's the very intimidating and awesome statue of the Colossus of Rhodes, I should say. And if we get this city, we capture that wonder. And that'll be 2 out of 7 wonders. So, plowing ahead on that victory condition. Be very nice for us. Let me take a drink, because I seem to be coughing. And no, I'm not a wheezing. Ha ha. Get it, Pokemon jokes? Anyway. I don't know where that shot went. But, again, hit delete to follow a unit, and if it's a ranged unit, such as Scorpions, you will be able to follow the projectiles. So, we can watch them cut down a couple men here with our Scorpions. Pretty low maintenance first army here. We just have to, you know, pepper at them with some ranged units and then surround them. Throw Histati and throw javelins, and they should rout. And if need be, we can fight them in melee. But it shouldn't come to that, really. The biggest threat probably is their general bodyguard. It's quite a big unit of... I think it's got some good experience on it, and the general's pretty powerful as far as his command rating, so... That'll be a little tough, but we have the numbers to fight him, so I'm not too worried about it. And we are cutting it down a decent number of men, but... You know, I'd still prefer, like, onagers or something. And even the Scorpions miss. And they're, like, the most accurate of range assault units. I don't know. Anyway, I'm going to turn off delete now, and we're going to form a little kill box here with our Histati. These three units on the edge are our best Histati. Form a little kill zone where we can fire javelins in at all angles. And now we got cavalry in the back, ideally. And then we can just charge in and crush all of them at once. And make the Scorpion stop firing, because we could probably get some friendly fire now. I think we already did, perhaps. I don't know. And these guys are getting chewed up with javelins in the front there. Move our cavalry to the back, as I said before. Can move these guys up into the kill zone a little better. Gotta watch their general in the background. He seems to be moving around a little erratically, so we don't want him to engage early. That would be bad. Keep our eyes on him. We already routed one unit. Routed two unit. And, you know what? Everybody just charge in on this guy here. You know, we should be able to crush him pretty easily. He just got too much against him. There we go. He's routed. So, pretty easy battle there. But the hard part is going to be the secondary force. And we'll zoom in here and watch the destruction of the Greeks. As they lose their first army. Yeah, okay. We need to... Pull the cavalry out, pull the cavalry out. He fainted a charge there. And now we're going to reform our Histati line. Oh, no time. And now we're going to swing around our Equites. Get some extra Histati over here. Get Gaius up here for support and maybe some fighting. And, okay, we're taking him down pretty well. He is hammering a couple of our units, but I think we got this. Pretty much in the bag. Yeah, he's already shaken, wavering. Should be going down pretty quickly here. He's doing a number on our troops, but that's what most general bodyguards do on very hard battle difficulty. So yeah, there we go. Oh, that was the king. Okay, that was the faction leader. The guy in Kaidonia must be the faction heir. I was mistaken. I'm sorry. Gosh, jeez. Come on, off my back, guys. Come on. Don't be so mean. Oh, there's another thunder. Na 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 thunder. Okay, I'm sorry. That song goes through my head every time. Thunderstorm. So, not my fault, right? I'm not the one that sang the song initially. Right? And that was a little sloppy Histati work there, I will admit. Let's try to get some behind the unit. That would probably work a little better. Yeah, we're losing a lot of men. There. Sometimes it's just not so good. I'll admit it. And there we go. Crushed that unit with sheer numbers. And it was militia hoplite, so I guess it didn't really matter too much. You know, we got the other unit of hoplites over here. Their last unit in Rhodes. The last defenders, basically. Should be able to cut them down pretty easily, I would imagine. They're getting shot down with our archers as well, so that works out in our favor. And we're going to have a little smash party. Smash party! Smash party! We are going to kill the Greeks. Yes. Oh, look at that. They saw the peel and they're like, oh my gosh! Better run! No! And now we're just going to kill zone them a little bit. Field of death as our general cleans up the other unit of militia hoplites. And I think we've killed enough to take the city. So we'll see. We'll see, though. Clear victory. They took about 200. We killed about 800. So that was pretty good. Any fight against the Greeks will take out a good chunk of your forces, at least 100. Because the Greeks are pretty powerful. But that went pretty well. And we took the city of Rhodes. Probably going to exterminate because we're kind of low on funds. And it already is a city, so it doesn't really matter too much. And see, this guy did survive. And he gained a command star for winning that battle, unfortunately. And here's the Colossus of Rhodes!
The capture of this great wonder is a magnificent feat by our troops, worthy of any great general. Hero of Rome, I mean. The Colossus increases naval trade by 40%.
Statue of Helios, the sun god. I don't think anybody worships so. I don't think you can have anyone worshiping Helios in this game. I don't know what he'd really do, but popularity gained with the masses, so that's cool. Sometimes that pops up, and that just means that you lost popularity and then you got it back in one turn. That seems to be common, but it's possible that we actually are up to 4 popularity. Although I wouldn't put any bets on it. And gonna go around building stuff. Syracuse started the proconsuls. Let's see if you didn't see that. In Lullibom, we're going to get some crop rotation as Sparta has finished the Legion's barracks, so we can go ahead and good stuff to train. We'll go with stone walls for defense. Actually, yeah, we need the population growth more than defenses. Corinth has their defenses here, and the following factions in declared lore, a bunch of them and stuff. So let's see the remnants of our army here. Oh gosh, there's not much left. A couple bedraggled Histati. Lots of injured mercenaries. We're going to send them over to Rhodes. And let's see what they have to retrain in Rhodes. They have a Temple of Athena. We don't need that. We'll get our Temple of get our own Temple of Saturn. And, oh, we can train some cavalry auxilia here. Histati, Equites, and Velites. So not too bad. And we'll merge these units and then retrain them, as per usual, because we do not want to lose any units. We don't need to, and we want to be able to retrain as much as we can in one turn. And it looks like they have some kind of blacksmith upgrade here that we don't get elsewhere, so kind of a little annoying, but yeah. All right, there we go. One turn of retraining. One unit, one new unit, and a bunch of retraining units. Always good. And, yeah, they don't have much going on in Cydonia. We did hurt their army pretty well, and their economy should be suffering if they only have one island settlement and we're blockading their port. So I don't expect them to be able to retrain too much of it. And they did spend a bunch of their money on mercenaries as well, so hopefully they're almost out. And we're going to defend Mediolanum here up with this guy until he dies or, you know, we take out Batavium and stuff. It looks like the Spanish are still trying to take out Carthaginian settlements with little success. But they'll probably succeed at some point. And the Spanish might become a difficult late-game adversary. Who knows? And we're going to save the game. We didn't save the game. We're going to end the turn. That's what I meant. I meant to say it! I'm sorry! Please forgive me. I didn't mean to. And Thapsus. Okay, we're not going to do that yet. Senate. We still got to finish our war over here. All our big navies are over here. We don't really need anything over there. And Publius Scipio is becoming a pretty good governor, as I surmised he would. So that's pretty cool. He's only 25, and he's got quite a bit of management and some influence. In Rhodes, we can go for second level of Temple of Saturn, get some more happiness here. Even though it's pretty good, we're gonna want to move out with these guys at some point. So there's that. We can move these Histati into the city. Injured Histati. And the archers, as well as the Equites. And then we can move He did get a trait there. Local hero, I believe, is what he got. So that's not too bad. We got all these agents in here. I guess we didn't really need them in this army. I kind of trained them to go, you know, annoy Carthage. But we'll get to that at some point. And this might be a little tedious, guys. So hold on. Hold on to your Snickers, because it's gonna be a little tedious. Just disbanding all these, you know, really bedraggled mercenaries that we can't retrain. And now we can retrain these units. Can't actually train archers, but we can upgrade their stats, I guess. And train another unit of Cavalry Auxilia, or our first unit. Everything else is looking pretty good. I guess we can move this navy. Actually, I have an idea here. We're going to move a couple of units here. About half of them, let's say. And about 4 out of 6. That's probably good. And we're going to send... Come on, there we go. We're going to send all of our agents. Except, no, we'll take our diplomat too. Because we haven't really talked to Numidia at all. And we'll take them. And we'll link up with this little navy here next turn. And then those guys will go out to Carthage, the Carthaginian era, go out to Africa, start spying, sabotaging buildings, assassinating diplomats and stuff, and you know, getting trade routes with like Numidia, forging alliances against the Carthaginians. And holy cow, they have a lot of units on this boat. And hopefully they stay on that boat, because we can take them down. We have superior naval power. So let's end the turn. Assistance has been requested by the House of Scipii, although nothing became of it. Which means the enemy army retreated, so that's fun. Keeping the forces there. We'll probably get a battle with them soon, I would imagine, but for now it's not really too hot up there. Even though they did take Mediolanum somehow, I don't know. And there we go, that settlement is... Oh, they sent the boat over here. Oh, it looks like they're going to go try to retake Rhodes, it would appear. And got a decent number of Senate positions. We have a consul now, so he's one of the top 4 men of the Senate, Quintus. So that's pretty cool. Quintus has become a pretty good guy. And we got some good guys in the rest of the Senate as well, so that's nice for us. We are the most advanced faction. Stole that from Egypt once more, so that's cool. And in Sparta, sewers are complete. And we're going to build some farms. We're just going to go for population growth there. And once it has stable growth, we may indeed engage. And as you saw there, the SPQR has declared an alliance with Macedon. So it's almost sacrilege to attack Macedon. And, yeah, so. Who knows how long it'll take us to take out the Greeks if it's sacrilege to attack Macedonians. And, we're going to engage this navy here. Clear victory, of course, because they have a small navy, so it doesn't really matter. And they have so many units in that boat. And we can't quite reach him, though. We can move the navy here. We can blockade his advance towards anything useful. I don't think he can get anywhere in one turn, so that'll be helpful. Take out that navy so he can't go assist. And I'll move the anti-Carthaginian navy eastward over here. Probably drop between Thespis and Carthage there. And that should be pretty good. Get some agent harassment. Operation Agent Storm is what I always call it when I use a lot of agents. I don't know, I'm dumb like that. We'll build some boats over in Rhodes so we can have a little local navy there, as well as a couple boats in Sparta. I know I'm trying to save up population, but adding a little more navy never hurts. So from now on, we're going to try to focus on a tough navy and kind of keep the waters under our control, because we have a lot of islands, so we need to do that. And as you saw, we built something in our capital. Kind of forgot about the capital because weren't able to build something, if you remember, at the end of last episode. But now we are, so back on the building queue it is. And everything's looking pretty good, so we're going to save it and end the turn. And assistance requested again, although nothing became of it again, which is fine. It looks like they're trying to move out with our army to take Batavium, perhaps. Little effort. And they, for some reason, they did not move the boat here. So we have a shot, We do indeed have a shot to take out pretty much their whole army. We're going to take this little expeditionary force to try to take them out. And fingers crossed, yes! Yes! Oh, yes. We took out the whole Greek army there with our navy. That is the coolest thing. Oh, yes. And anyway, we're going to build some archery ranges in Rhodes. And we'll keep the archers here so they can retrain. And we're going to move out with a bunch of our Histati and cavalry. And we don't need to take our general, because we already have the general in the boats, I believe, if I recall. And we'll send this out, and he'll go attack Kydonia, and he should be able to take it out pretty easily, because it's just the faction leader now in there, so nothing of interest, really. They sent all of their army in that one boat, and then the boat got sunk, and yeah, that was pretty awesome. And we're building navy, as I said before. Sana has finished a wooden wall. We go for a stone wall. Get a good wall in our capital. I don't expect any sea invasions by anybody, but you never know. And I'll build some roads there. And in roads, we're already building an archer range. And I'll link up with a little bit of our local navy, local biremes. And these guys will come down and link up next turn. And this Carthaginian fleet is moving, so that's good. And everything else is looking pretty good. It looks like Thrace is doing pretty well. They've taken out enemy land. It looks like they're trying to take out that next station settlement. So, pretty interesting. And, we got the Brutii in here, too. So it's the Brutii, Julii, and Scipii in one area fighting one common enemy. That's kind of cool. Whoa, Syracuse is really unhappy, but, yeah, they're about to grow next turn, so that's not too big a deal. And I'll get rid of a lot of the culture penalty as well, because they pretty much updated all the buildings, I think. So, no worries there. And I'm trying to think of anything else we need to do now. I don't think there is. Still no buildings. Corinth is getting pretty close to city status, so that'll be nice. And we'll save it. And just make sure nothing else. No army on that boat. And, it looks like Pontus is taking out the Egyptian settlements. I've totally forgotten about this diplomat. So we're going to move him down. And, yeah, it looks like... Actually, it looks like perhaps Pontus is trying to get an upper hand here, so we may have to go to war with Pontus at some point. This is requested here. And, we did get in a fight. Very useless fight. High experience on these Gallic units, but there's not very many of them at all. Excuse me while I take a drink. Thank you for waiting so patiently, my beloved fans. You are... the apple of my eye. What? I don't know. The man who runs away will fight again. As did our commander Asinius, I believe is his name. He ran away, and now he gets to fight again. But better still to live and tell our grandchildren, as yet unborn, of brave Romans who fought well. I don't think I've ever seen that line, but pretty nice line, I guess. We're not going to really fight. Because by the time we get into the action, it'll probably already be over. So there's really no point in fighting in this battle. But we'll see what the Julii commander is capable of. And we'll see if the Gauls can actually do any damage to him. Gauls have about 200 men, so... I mean, we can take it out with our cavalry contingent, basically. Well, probably not. They have good experience. We'll form up battle lines just in case. Don't want to be caught unprepared, I guess. So there's that. Make sure our cavalry is in position as well. large percentage of this force is mercenary, but that's fine. We don't really have a base up here to retrain forces, so that's to be expected, I suppose. They do have some Samnite gladiators, which is interesting. Pretty decent units. And we may train our gladiators at some point, but you know, I'm not a real big fan of gladiators. I like the Romans, pure Romans better. And now these skirmishers are gonna get charged by one of their heavy cavalry units, and they got... Yeah, it's not looking good for them already. These warbands can actually probably do a number on these generals, but on very hard battle difficulty, your ally army and your enemy army perform at the same skill level. So it's like an even battle between... It's like fighting at medium battle difficulty between those two. So the Julii don't receive any penalty like we would if we were fighting the Gauls. Which is very strange, but that's how it works. Oh, and look at that! They lost. The Gauls made a nice move and sneak attack these ballista, but they don't have enough men to even kill it. So that's kind of depressing. These ballista engineers are able to take down these warbands. So, it was worth a shot. I applaud the Gaul for a little smart maneuver there, but he did not have the manpower. And, we'll end the battle. Really no point in continuing. They only killed about 17 of us Romans, so that's fine. And, pretty uneventful. Hopefully we'll get an eventful battle soon. Batavium is still well congested, and we're going to have to unentrench them slowly, but I think we can do it. And the Gauls still want a ceasefire. I'm just going to say no. Might as well keep fighting them. Assistance requested once more. Let's accept. And they retreated, so that's fine. And ceasefire... No. Did you see what they're offering? They want us to give us 3 settlements and 10,000 denarii for a ceasefire. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me, Greek cities? I don't know. Whatever. And we got a couple more, 2 more turns until we land over there in Africa. And we should be able to spread out and infiltrate Africa and make it pretty easy for us to take out, I would say. Syracuse has finished his peasants. Capua has finished sewers. We could go for public baths or blacksmith. Or we could go for legionary barracks so we can get principes up there. We're going to need Capua to have some kind of military prowess at some point. But I won't go into that at this moment. There's a lot that I'm not going into until later. But I don't want to spoil anything. If this is the first time you've ever seen Rome Total War, I'm trying not to spoil too much for you. So, yeah. And things are looking pretty good. Oh, we can attack this Greek navy here. Or we could just land our troops. I think that's a better option. And we'll siege a settlement here. We'll probably siege assault because they have 2 units in there. Might as well get these Rhodian mercenaries, and we did not get a mercenary captain once more. That's unfortunate. Move these guys back down, and combine the navy there. Pull these guys over and combine the navy. Got a pretty big navy over here once more, and that's looking pretty good. We'll actually take off these ships. We don't really need that many more. You know, we can almost get over there, so next turn we can combine the navies. Yeah, pretty good-sized navy. Probably won't need too much more. We'll probably just try to maintain that navy instead of building more naval units. And I'll probably build up our naval forces over on the west, but for now, I think we have enough. And we'll trade with the Parthians here. Trade rights. And map information. And looks like Parthia is not doing so hot, I guess. Looks like the Egyptians are responsible for taking out the Seleucids in the east. And they do have a large city, though, so... That means they can train potentially cataphracts, so they could be threatening. But who knows if they're actually doing that. And, yeah, everything's looking pretty good. Pontus still has quite a few settlements over here, but a lot of them are towns. And did I see... I don't think Pergamum had walls, as strange as that may seem. But that might just be a little glitch. I don't know. That would be kind of weird if they didn't have walls, I guess. I don't know what I'm saying. The computer is usually pretty fervent about building at least some walls. And my nose is really starting to run all of a sudden. I don't know why. I think maybe it's the weather. When it gets rainy out, my nose gets a little rainy too. So, I don't know. And Batavium is a large city, as you can see. So, that is a little something. And the turn has been ended. Gauls are moving in some more reinforcements. Greeks not doing anything, of course. And holy cow, they've surrounded us with an army of crap. Or lots of crap units. Oh my gosh, we can't even move. Balenus the Lewd, nice. And we got a Julii family member running away. I think we're just going to chill there. There's really no point. If they want to attack us, go ahead. But whatever. And Leibom is growing to a large city as well. So the island of Sicily has become very, very big as far as its settlements. Which is usually what happens. And that's why I say the Scipii have a very very nice. After a rough beginning, they have a very nice position. And I'll take out this little Greek navy here. Blockade the port. Not that it really matters, I guess. Because they can't train units anyway, so they don't really need money for anything. And we'll go down to Sidon here. And I guess I should trade with the Egyptians. Hey, I didn't even do that. So let's do that. Sorry. And we're seeing 2,000 for map information is worth it, in my opinion. So they still have Salamis. I believe they start with Salamis. And they have a few settlements around here. Down here is some of the largest settlements in the game. They have these settlements here. And like before, we saw that they have these settlements over here. Perhaps Pontus just caught him off guard or something. I'm not sure. We'll have to watch. We'll right-click and drag around here eventually. Every once in a while to see how Pontus versus Egypt is doing. And we'll try to fight the winning side so that we can get an advantage in the area. Because if we fight the losing side, the winning side is going to gain such an advantage that it's going to be hard to defeat them. And we are going to have to fight Macedon eventually, or her, try to get the Brutii involved in the war, because I don't want, because you're going to have to take that line eventually, so might as well. And now we're going to siege attack Eumenes of Sparta, so let's go! Yeah! Woo! The last Greek city stand with 2 units of cavalry, I believe. Very interesting. No hoplites, no infantry, very un-Greek-like defending navy in the last settlement. At Crete, and it's a city, so I mean it's a pretty big settlement. Good for them. In the standard version, Kydonia actually is pretty good settlement. It's hard to get going because they have some pretty strong rebels defending, but it has some good growth rates and it's in a good position for trade, so it's a pretty good settlement to pick up in vanilla. But of course, as you saw, I did mod it a little bit so that the Greek cities start with Kydonia, and it is a large town at the beginning of the game. So, there's that. But, yeah. Turn on fire at will mode on the Sestati. And I suppose I should mention for you new guys that are like, what, you're modding the game? Yeah, I mod the game because I like it so much that I've had to add balance. I've added what I view as balance to the game. And I've finally made my addition. After the last LP, I had finally compiled my edition of more realistic starting positions and stuff. But if you're wondering how to make these mods that I'm talking about, I do have a video on my channel called Brainlord's Guide to Text Modding, and you can go check that out. It should answer a bunch of questions, and if there's anything unanswerable, you can leave a question on there, on that video, question and a comment on that video. Or you can personal message me a question. If you're too embarrassed or something to ask, which seems very odd. And here's the new unit here, Cavalry Auxilia. Haven't seen these guys before. Basic Javcav, and Javcav are my favorite unit. If you've watched any of my other LPs where I have Javcav. And Javcav are my favorite unit. But as the Romans, they aren't very widely used. But I'll try to use them where I can, of course. And now we're going to knock down the gates, yeah. And, The revenge of this commander. He's like, hey dude, hey, remember when you routed that whole pack of units and we could have won? Well, I'm gonna come kill you, so ha. And you know what, I think we can just go with a cavalry assault here. To be honest, we don't really need much more. We have cavalry superiority as it is, so we can go for a cavalry assault on them. Move them into the city. And we should be good from there. So how's it going today, guys? It is August something, 13th, I believe. And yeah, we had a nice couple storms today. Pretty good. We haven't gotten rain in a couple weeks. So a good storm session is always appreciated. Usually doesn't storm that much in August, but... it's never appreciated. Holy cow, is it hard enough to get these units to form into line here? And, triple speed again. Again, it's been pretty cold recently. I don't know why. It's very odd. Very odd. It feels like fall already, which is kind of depressing. And, I do have to go back to college in 2 weeks, and, What that means for you guys, what college means for you guys, is that I probably won't be able to upload a video every day. Every other day is more realistic. My first LP, Pontus, was made entirely while I was at college, and that was about every other day, or if I was in a busy period, maybe once a week, twice a week. But yeah, I kept I had at least one or two uploads a week, so the upload count will drop, but we'll still be chucking these things out, so don't worry about that. And also the quality will have to drop, because the internet connection there is pretty low compared to at my house, so we're going to go back down to 720p, and it shouldn't look too much more different. It's just there won't be any option for 1080p, and it might look a little pixelated, but I think you guys can handle it, right? So, yeah. And we're just move all the cavalry inside here, and if they start to charge us, we will deal accordingly, of course. And they are firing javelins at us, because they do have JavCav, so... They do have JavCav. And we took control of the place there for a second, that was cool. And, okay, we're going to engage the English Cav now, get our general in here, and we should be able to outflank them. We're going to fire at their general with our militia cav as well. And we should be able to take these guys out pretty easily, I would imagine. Remember that they cannot rout because they're in the city center. But I thought I told you to fire javelins. Whatever, you can fight in melee if you want, I guess. If you're that happy about it. And, yeah. I guess everybody attack the general's bodyguard because this militia cav are almost dead. So, sort of the attack on all of these guys. Sonic Cry Command, these couple of our units are getting injured a little bit, so we need to do that. And they're shaking. Oh, they might rout. Hold on, guys. Come on. Hold your ground. We got this if we just surround them a little bit. There we go. We're cutting them down. Hey, I said don't rout. Hold your ground. Do you not know what that means? We got our general in here, and yeah, our general bodyguard has more than theirs, so we have an advantage. So I think we should be able to win this. A little sloppy with the cav, but you know what? I like to expedite things sometimes if I know there's low chance of losing. So I wasn't too worried about this. And we should be able to cut down the rest of them here. Three more guys there. And the last Greeks are going down. The last Greek cities. There's still Macedonians and Thracians, of course, but... And we're going to end the battle. We're not even going to kill the last three guys, just because we're weird like that. This is the news of war and infinite money, says Cicero. I don't know. Whatever, how you say that. And with that, we take Kydonia. As you saw, it was red, so we're definitely going to have to exterminate. And the Greek cities have been eliminated, so that's one faction that has been shot down by the Romans. So... the other faction that died was the Seleucid Empire, and now the Greek cities have been eliminated as well. And we can retrain our cavalry here, not our JavCav. Oh, we can't retrain our JavCav. Oh, we'll get rid of their temple, even though it is a pretty good temple. We'll get our Temple of Saturn here. And I guess we'll have some injured JavCav. That's fine, I guess. And keep the ships here. Nothing really more we need to do. Athens is lightly defended. We may actually go sneak attack Athens. We can probably want to break the alliance so that we don't lose diplomatic ripper. if you betray an enemy nation, I believe you lose favor with other nations. But anyway, we're gonna do that next time. This has been going pretty long. Sorry about that. Thanks for watching this episode. I can't talk. Thanks for watching this episode of Rome Total War Scipii. And join me next time when we launch some agents over to Carthage, perhaps attack it, and perhaps we will go attack Macedon as well. See how the cookie crumbles, how the cards unfold, how the cheeseburger does stuff. Okay, bye.